Yeah, my production house, Pooja Mishra Productions, is in pre-production for my reality show, Spare Me the Crab Mentality. Now that's a show I've been wanting to make for a really long time because I feel that we've got so many iconic people who are living the quintessential dream. You know, the American dream is being lived by Jennifer Lopez, who started from the bylanes of Bronx, which is a small suburb. And today she's all over the place. She's an icon. So why don't we have such an iconic figure in Bollywood? You know, probably because there's a lot of crab mentality here. People don't want to see you do well and come up. Unfortunately, that is true. And nobody's spoken up about it because, you know, there's this hypocrisy of wailing other people's insecurities. But me being the upfront, straightforward person, I want to talk about it. I want to do a show about it. And I want to use that show as a platform to fulfill people's dream to be a part of Bollywood. So I would imagine it's a bloody damn good endeavor.
So according to you, which topic is the crab mentality?
Well, actually, I have suffered a lot in my life. And I've been also delayed endlessly because of the crab mentality. And if you see the logo of my production house, it says Pooja Mishra Productions, cracking the crab mentality. So, well, actually, I've just lodged a domestic violence case wherein I've had certain film families, you know, really, really trying to block my progress, delay it, rob all my hard work and not even acknowledge me. And that's been really hurtful as a journey because I've always had high regards for everybody. But such kind of prolonged torture. I mean, when you talk about Pooja Mishra, the first thing that comes to people's mind is, haan haan, wo Big Boss wali, haan haan, wo jo bahut jhagde karti thi. Now, not many people know that all those aggressive fights inside Big Boss's house, and even when I came out, there were a couple of viral videos which were all over the media websites, were all manipulated and literally I was framed into doing all of that. Now you'll say, aisa kaise ho sakta hai? So let me explain. Would you all know what is mentalism? Would you all know what's hypnosis? Well, these are crafts which are used for medicinal healing of patients, you know, medical hypnosis and all of that. But when put in wrong hands, it can really be used to ruin people's lives because a mentalist has been used on me to drive me insane, to do crazy things, you know, just so that I could be maligned in the media, so that my career wouldn't progress. I mean, I remember I have always been a certain personality. I didn't know a word of Hindi, you know. I was like a cathedralite, South Mumbai girl. And my personality was literally eroded by mentalism because I was made to talk in a certain way. I wasn't allowed to speak English. Everywhere I went, Hindi bolo, Hindi bolo. Every night when I used to go to sleep, I used to dread it because in the apartment above mine would be sitting a mentalist or a thought reader, you know, doing all these freaky things to my brains. So I mean, at one point I realized my brains are not in my control. My body is not in my control. And I didn't want to live this life of a slave anymore. You know, we all are born free. We all are free to live our life. I wasn't even allowed to live my life. That's why I'm making the song Hotter Than You, because I want people to go out there, dance, enjoy, because I was not allowed to dance and enjoy. I was forced to stay at home. I could not party. I could not act my age. I wasn't allowed to have boyfriends. I need to understand what kind of a cage can you put someone into mentally, and how fair is this? It's absolutely illegal. And that's why I've gone and lodged a domestic violence case in the High Court, Bombay. I've been, that's why I wait, because I also am fighting my own case. I'm an advocate. And it's been very, very, very traumatizing for me to relive the nightmare I've been facing for 13 years. Can you imagine 25 Bollywood movies? From Dabang to Yamna Pagla Diwana to Jism 2 to Mirzia to a Punjabi film called Yodha. So many movies. Rahul Ravel's movie in which we had Sunny Deol saying no if, no but, just jut, which was being shot in New York. I was approached for that as well. So I mean, all these movie offers that I got through hack phones, through a mentalist, through this lady herself sitting on my head every night, and I'm talking about Sonakshi Sinha here, you know, they ruined my career. They stole my movies. You know, every human being has got certain phases in life. Mm-hmm. If you've read the Manusmriti, what does the Manusmriti say? That there are four parts of a man's life. You know, this childhood, then there is a time when he's finding his bearings and finding a job, adolescence, then there's married life, and then there's old age. So why are you not letting my phase of my life where I want to build a career and move forward and have a personal life, probably get married, have kids, settle down, why are you not letting me progress into that? You've trapped me into one chapter of my life and you're just not letting me go. You know, and mentalism used not only to make me go crazy and do freaky things, speak Hindi, abuse. There were so many times when I was abusing and I didn't even know what the abuse meant. You know, so all this was done intentionally. Do you know mentalism can be used to, you know, spoil your stomach, to attack your digestive system, to break your hand, to break your foot, to break your nose? I've been through that. And that's why the domestic violence case, you can't keep on breaking somebody's bones and think that nobody will ever find out. And this is a serious issue one needs to address. Now, if you're going to go ask Sonakshi, what do you have to say about it? She'll probably say, oh, no comments, publicity stunt. It's not a publicity stunt. It is a properly documented high court case with proof. Please understand. And if I haven't spoken up about it for so long, I've just been dignified enough not to. But considering they're continuing with this day in, day out, they put some cameras in my Pune bungalow. They've purposely banned me from my society. I've got an apartment in Bombay where I stay. They've got me banned from my own apartment, my own family house that we own. And they have got no summons from the court for it. It's not legal. They've just paid the board of directors in Ajmera Society, Windsor Towers, where I used to stay. And they've gotten me out of my own apartment because they don't want me to stay in Bombay. They don't want me to work. They don't want me to do movies. But then I need to understand, who are they? And what control do they have over my life? They were my, Mr. Shatrughan Sinha was my father's college friends. They went to Patna University together, right? So you are a legacy of loss which has been handed over to me by my parents. I don't even know you. And very honestly, I don't even want to, right? So would you please stop this nonsense and stop controlling my brain, my body and my life? I just want to live, I want to breathe, I want to just let go of all of this. If you let go of me, you know, you find a Sone Ki Chidiya, on whose hard work you're making crores, you're getting a lot of movies, you're giving some to your daughter, you're giving some to Salman Khan's girlfriends because you want to butter him up because he launched your daughter. Why are you using my hard work and me as a pawn in a game of chess? Mohra? That's what I've been all this while, a puppet in the puppeteer's hand. And who's been the puppeteer? The mentalist. Sonakshi herself can read your mind. Do you know that? She's been trained from childhood in hypnosis and mentalism. She can read your thoughts. When I went for the music release of Mera Dil Leke Dekho, the movie I'd done for Shotgun Productions, the first film that I'd done, and that's where I committed suicide in my career by doing their film as the first because they didn't let me come up after that. I was offered Dabang, Arbaz's secretary called me up, but I immediately refused it because they were doing mentalism on me. My brain was in their hands. They made me refuse it and they planted their daughter there. And then all these Fashion Week showstoppers they kept on stealing off me. All these 25 movies that I was being considered for and finalized for, they kept on robbing off me. I mean, please tell me, is this being normal? So who is the psychotic here? Is it me who was alone? My parents, after my father's retirement in 2005, shifted to Pune. I was living alone in Bombay. So what was my fault in all of this? That I was talented? I was more stylish, I was better spoken, I was more superior than your daughter. So you did all these things to me to make me out to be crazy and stole my movies to hack phones so that you could just bury me alive. How fair is this? People need to know this, that Pooja Mishra is not what you see her or perceive her to be. She's bigger than what her image claims to be, that she's crazy and she's scary and she fights. Please understand, that wasn't me, that was a mentalist that was being forced onto me. They were controlling my mind, they were controlling my body. I have been sexually abused for 13 long years without knowing it, because they make you unconscious and then they use you sexually, and in the morning when you get up with all these diseases, And you're wondering, I am a brahmachari. I am a celibate. I am a Brahmin. Till date, I've not been in a relationship. Till date, I've not consensually been intimate with anybody. And you guys are just like using me and kicking me around. And I'm not like some uneducated, hijab-wearing, maid that you've made me out to be. I'm educated, I'm qualified, good enough to fight my own case in high court. Excuse me, that says a lot about, being a strong woman. And trust me, I wasn't born an advocate. I learned it the hard way. Because I hired 9 lawyers, from Ram Jethmalani to Nayak and Nayak to all the top-notch lawyers who sit in Cuff Parade, all studied from New York and practicing in India. And they all said, oh, we'll help you. And when the date came in the court to represent me, they wouldn't turn up. So they would take the money and they would ditch me at the end moment. You see? So I learned law. In these 13 years, I learned law. And I'm fighting my own cases. And I've lodged an out and out case against Mr. Shatrughan Sinha on 20th April 2017 in High Court. You can check it on the High Court website. For domestic violence. Because they were living in the apartment above mine, they were controlling my brains, they were stealing my work, they were using my body and getting it used by other people in Bollywood to further Sonakshi's career. I'm sorry, you don't have that much of control in my life. Very honestly, I don't even allow my parents, my father and mother whose blood runs in my veins, I don't allow them to do that to me. Then who in the hell are you guys? Please tell me. And what was my fault in all of this? I was alone. That's it. So is this how safe a girl alone in Mumbai city is? I would like to ask Mr. Dev Fadnis this, who is the chief minister of Maharashtra, a well-educated girl, daughter of chief commissioner of income tax, living alone in her own apartment, trapped by her father's friends. How fair is that? I mean, if this is going to start happening in the educated circles, then you can just imagine what's going to happen in the slums. So, I mean, this is all really wrong, and thank God, and thanks to my good karmas, I'm coming out of it, I'm lodging complaints after complaints, police complaints in Pune, because they keep on still harassing me every day. I'll book an Ola cab, suddenly it'll go off, suddenly my mother will come charging at me when I'm giving an interview on the phone, because they don't want me to be in the media. Whenever something good is happening, my mother will come and she'll start acting crazy and shouting at me, my father will start hitting me. It's the mentalist who's working on all the members of the family's minds. They have trapped us by that. And you can go check it up. It does happen and it can be done. And I'll even give you his name, Mr. Shastri. His name is Shastri. So, I mean, all this is like totally psychotic. And those viral videos, the one at Karol Bagh and the one about beating hotel staff, that was all planned. The mentalist was positioned in the hotel that you make her get angry, and these hotel staffs were all briefed that you go and you irritate her, instigate her, provoke her, and then those videos were made and sold to the media, and 8 crores was earned on that. Do you know that? I just did an analysis on Google and on YouTube that how much of money was earned out of defaming me, and 8 crores was earned out of that. And even Miss Malini, who's a blogger and who's like always fangs out, did write in a post that Sonakshi Sinha made that video viral. So, I mean, they're earning money out of me. They've kept me like a toy, like a pawn in front of the whole Bollywood industry. They're making a blithering idiot out of me. For how long am I going to stay in the cage? Well, it ends here. And whosoever has supported them intentionally or unintentionally is also going to be pulled out. Because you can't do this to somebody. And not to somebody like me, who's educated and genuinely a nice person out there to help others. My only fault was I wasn't competitive enough. My only fault was I wasn't ruthless enough. I was always nice. And I just feel I've lived my life, 13 years of my life, for them. I don't think I live the past 13 years of my life for myself. So what does it feel like to wake up from a 13-year-long nightmare? That's what I feel like right now. Just woken up from a 13-year-old nightmare, which has robbed everything of me, left me with nothing. But yes, I'm strong and I will not give up. So here I am talking to you all, telling you my story so that you learn from it. tomorrow your cousin or your sister or your mother is staying alone, she doesn't fall victim to a mentalist, or your family for that matter. You know, there is a book called The Celestine Prophecy. And what is the Celestine Prophecy? There's nothing called as coincidence. Everything was planned in these 13 years. My whole downfall and how to keep me spiraling down. You know, I had a friend, Tanuj Garg. He was the CEO of Balaji Telefilms. He used to study with me in Cathedral and John Cannon when my father was here, still in service. And these people didn't have control over me. Once he retired, they started all this, which has been 13 years now. So Tanuj used to make these, dummy examination papers and mail them to me, you know, so that I do well in the exams. So he's been my childhood friend. Today, he doesn't even pick up my call. Why? Why have all my friends deserted me? Thanks to Sonakshi Sinha. Everywhere she goes, she's probably negating me. And everybody just seems to have abandoned me. Because they've made such a mess out of me, you know. Use my body, use my mind. What would it feel like to live a life where you have no control over your body, you have no control over your mind? It would be like a walking dead body, right? Walking, talking dead body. So I've lived that life for 13 years.
Nowadays, Bollywood actors are turning into a singer. Nowadays, Bollywood actors are turning into a singer. So what's your take on that? Because they should stick to their acting career or they should sing also.
No, I feel
because
that...
recently, Sonakshi also have debuted as a singer in a movie. So what do you like to say about it?
No, I just would like to say that, singers work very hard. जो लोग गाना गाते हैं वो बहुत मेहनत करते हैं, हर सुबह उठ के वो रियाज करते हैं, बहुत सारे खाना अवॉइड करते हैं. They can't eat everything, you know, because their throat gets sore. They pray to Saraswati Mata every morning. So they really respect and value their craft. And they know their niche. They know that this is my niche and I want to excel in the field of singing. So I think everybody should stick to their niche. If I want to be an actress, I should stick to that, right? Okay, a song here, a song there, shock ke liye, theek hai, gana ga diya, that's allowed, you know, that's okay. But like, you can't literally rob people of their bread and butter and their job and their niche. You know, wo bolte na, jack of all trades, master of none. I don't think anybody wants to be that. And if actors are getting into full-time singing and robbing other singers of concerts, then that's what they're doing. Jack of all trades, master of none.
So we have came from a non-Indian background, and you have given a huge response. We have got the fame. So have you faced any nepotism in our industry?
Absolutely. What I was talking about was the nepotism I faced. You know, to the extent, like I said, jahan aapka dimag aapke control mein nahi hai, aapki body aapke control mein nahi hai, aap ek bebas puppet ki tarah kisi aur ke liye naach rahe ho. Who would want to live a life like that? Aap batao, kya aap aisi zindagi basar karna pasand karoge? You know, where you can't even live your life. Main bahar nahi ja sakti, main party nahi kar sakti. I can't have a personal life. I can't have some friends who make me feel better, who I can talk to. Bilkul isolate karke ivory tower mein ek pagal mentalist ke saath bitha rakha hai pagal karne ke liye. To phir ye kaun tolerate karega? Aur jaise ki maine aapko bataya, Sonakshi khud hypnosis or mentalism janti hai. Agar wo aapke saath khadi hai, wo aapki thoughts read kar sakti hai. Use bachpan se Shatrughan Sinha ne train kiya hai is sab mein. Jisse use upper hand mile apne co-stars ke saath jab wo ek film shoot pe ho. That is fine, but don't misuse it because that's illegal. You get it?
You have been a VJ, then an actress. You have seen a peak point of your heart. Then you have not reached that kind of fame.
Yeah.
So what went wrong according to you?
Well, actually, jaise maine aapko bola, pichle 13 saal mein mere ko 25 films ke liye consider aur finalize kiya ja raha tha. Mera mobile phone hack kar rakha tha. और जैसे कि मैंने आपको बताया मेंटलिस्ट को इस्तेमाल किया जा रहा था मेरे दिमाग को कंट्रोल करने के लिए. तो अगर मुझे कॉल आ रहा है डायरेक्टर का कि आप कल रिहर्सल पे आइए, मैं खुद ही ओ आई एम नॉट फीलिंग वेल आई कैन मेक इट बोल देती थी क्योंकि मेरा दिमाग मेरे कंट्रोल में नहीं था. प्लीज़ अंडरस्टैंड. और आज जब मुझे ये सारी बातें पता चल रही हैं, इतनी लेट पता चल रही है, पर देर आए दुरुस्त आए, जब उठो तभी सवेरा है. इट्स बेटर लेट देन नेवर, राइट? And I would say, मेरे हमेशा सबके लिए कर्मास अच्छे रहे हैं. मैंने कभी किसी को hurt नहीं किया है. Neither am I a very greedy person, you know. ना ही मैं कोई cutthroat कंपटीशन में बिलीव करती हूँ, क्योंकि उस हिसाब से जिस हिसाब से इन लोगों ने मेरे साथ ये सब किया है, अगर मैं इनके जैसी होती तो यू नो व्हाट वुड हैव हैपेंड, आई थिंक वर्ल्ड वॉर 3, राइट? सो व्हाटएवर इट इज़, जो भी हुआ ये सब बहुत गलत हुआ. और मीडिया मुझसे पूछती है कि आप सोनाक्षी के बारे में आपने ऐसा बोला, क्या उसने आपको फ़ोन करके सॉरी बोला, क्या उसने आपको फ़ोन करके आपको कोई जस्टिफिकेशन दिया? एंड आई से नो, वो लोग फ़ोन तक नहीं करते क्योंकि दे आर गिल्टी. वो इग्नोर कर देते, आप उन्हें फ़ोन करोगे वो नहीं आपका फ़ोन उठाएंगे, और उल्टा अपने पब्लिसिटी से बोलेंगे, मीडिया में जाके बोलो पब्लिसिटी स्टंट कर रहे हैं. अभी आप देखो, एक बार बात होती तो आदमी समझ सकता है ओके मे बी दैट्स फॉर पब्लिसिटी. बार 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 आप कर रहे हो, किसी की आप 25 फिल्में चुरा के बैठे हुए हो, उसका फ़ोन हैक करके हर रात आप मेरे घर के ऊपर वाले घर में बैठ के मेरे दिमाग को यू नो नेगेटिव थॉट्स से भर रहे हो, क्योंकि आपके पास वो पावर है मेंटलिज्म और हिप्नोसिस का. आपके पिताजी आपके माताजी ने यू नो सिंस यू वर किड आपको ये सब सिखाया है, तो आप उसे मिसयूज क्यों कर रहे हो, किसी की ज़िंदगी क्यों खराब कर रहे हो? कैन यू इमेजिन, देयर वाज अ गाय हु आई वाज फ्रेंडली विथ, वो मेरे दोस्त जैसे थे, और वो लोग जानते थे अकेली रह रही है बॉम्बे में, तो वो लोग काफ़ी प्रोटेक्टिव थे मेरे बारे में. तो सोनाक्षी सिन्हा के फादर, और फिर उसकी शादी हो गई, तो सोनाक्षी सिन्हा के फादर शत्रुघ्न सिन्हा ने मुझे ऐसा दिखाया कि वो मुझे उस फैमिली से प्रोटेक्ट कर रहे हैं. एंड आज मुझे 13 साल बाद ये बात पता चली है कि सोनाक्षी सिन्हा खुद उस मैरिड मैन को डेट कर रही थी, और उनके फादर मुझे ऐसे दिखा रहे थे कि नहीं नहीं हम उनके बहुत बड़े दुश्मन हैं और वो आपके पीछे है, हम आपको प्रोटेक्ट कर रहे हैं. और असली में शत्रुघ्न सिन्हा एंड हिज फैमिली मेरे पीछे पड़े हुए थे, बिकॉज दे कांट सी मी प्रॉस्पर, दे कांट सी मी सक्सेसफुल, दे कांट इवन सी अ पिक्चर ऑफ माइन बीइंग पब्लिश्ड इन द पेपर. मेरी एक फोटो छप जाती है, ये लोग यू नो फायर ब्रिगेड मंगाने की ज़रूरत पड़ जाती है, दे आर दैट जेलस. मैं बस ये जानना चाहती हूँ, आप लोग का हक क्या है मेरी ज़िंदगी पे? आप लोग का हक क्या है? आप मेरे लिए एक लेगेसी ऑफ लॉस हो, मेरे पेरेंट्स के दिया हुआ सर का दर्द. यू आर माई फादर्स फ्रेंड नॉट माइन, सो स्टॉप फ्राइंग माई ब्रेन्स थ्रू अ मेंटलिस्ट, बिकॉज अब मेरे को सब पता चल गया आप लोग करते क्या हो, यू नो. एंड इट्स रियली सैड, एंड आई वॉन्ट एवरीबडी टू नो दिस, सो दैट दे गेट टू नो हु इज द रियल साइको, हु इज द रियल साइको हियर. डू आई हैव टू नेम हर? हर रात अगर आप आके किसी के सर पे बैठ रहे हो, मोबाइल हैक करके उसका काम चुरा रहे हो 13 साल से, उसका कहीं पब्लिसिटी नहीं होने दे रहे हो, यू ट्राइंग टू ड्राइव समबडी क्रेजी. They want me to commit suicide, you know that? So, this is like too much of torture, too many games, like a little toy, you know? Playing with me like a little pawn in a game of chess. Ki ye mora istemal karo use kaatne ke liye. I'm sorry. Thanks, but no thanks. I refuse to have anything to do with them. That's why I've lodged a domestic violence case, जिसमें मैंने एक restraining order के लिए request किया है कि मैं इन लोगों को बिल्कुल अपनी ज़िंदगी से dismiss और restrain कराना चाहती हूँ. I don't want them anywhere close to me, क्योंकि इन लोगों को mentalism और hypnosis आता है, वो उसे बहुत बुरी तरीके से misuse करते हैं. So that's it, that's the truth, and it's out of the bag, the cat is out of the bag finally. The world should know, क्योंकि ये सब इन्होंने सिर्फ मेरे साथ नहीं किया है, इन्होंने ये सब सलमान खान के साथ भी किया है, कई एक्टर्स के साथ किया है जिसके साथ सोनाक्षी ने मूवीज़ की हैं. और क्यों किया है? क्योंकि वो पूरी दुनिया को दिखाना चाहते हैं कि सलमान हमारे साथ है, सलमान तुम्हें ह्यूमिलिएट कर रहा है क्योंकि वो हमारा है. आई मीन वाओ, प्लीज कीप हिम एंड हिज होल फैमिली टू, बट व्हाई डू यू हैव टू ह्यूमिलिएट मी इन द प्रोसेस? व्हाट आर यू ट्राइंग टू प्रूव थ्रू द वर्ल्ड? आप प्रूव क्या करना चाह रहे हो? How insecure is that? खुद आप mentalism करा के किसी के digestive system से खेल रहे हो, फिर आप सलमान से गाना गवा रहे हो उसके बारे में. What's with that? Isn't that highly immature? I think एक 16 साल की बच्ची भी उससे ज़्यादा maturity रखती है. आप दिखाना क्या चाह रहे हो पूरी दुनिया में कि सोनाक्षी सिन्हा क्या कोई means एक थी Madonna और एक है सोनाक्षी सिन्हा? आप दिखाना क्या चाह रहे हो? What are you trying to prove to the world? और कब तक आपकी ये फांदेबाजी चलेगी, दोगलेबाजी, गोलमाल आपका? Today the game ends. This is where it ends.